UFOs, aliens, ghosts, psychic phenomena, lost civilizations, abductions, you name it, we talk about it, because this is Whitley Strieber's Dreamland, where we go farther out on the edge than any other radio program out there. You will hear things here that you have never heard before, and you will never hear anywhere else. So fasten your seatbelts and get ready to fly. I'm going to take you for a ride to Dreamland.
This is William Henry from Nashville. This is Dreamland. Welcome to one of the world's greatest mysteries, the mystery of Fulcanelli and the secret of alchemy. Jay Weidner has been on the trail of Fulcanelli and the secrets of alchemy since 1986. In his book, The Mysteries of the Great Cross of Henday and a Monument to the End of Time, Jay cracked the code of this mysterious pillar of Henday. He used that pillar as a needle to thread together a profound tapestry of secrets about our galactic center and this very moment in time in which we live. Jay's a hermetic scholar, he's a filmmaker, and a husband to the beautiful Sharon Rose. A Dreamland favorite, he returns with his Fulcanelli-inspired must-see DVD, Secret of Alchemy, The Great Cross and the End of Time. And you need to get it from the Unknown Country store right now. Buy the DVD. Watch it. What Jay is offering is a major clue to the mystery of our times. Jay, welcome to Dreamland.
Hey, William.
Hey, it's great to have you here. How are you?
I'm great. It's really great to be here.
Yeah, it's a nice turn of events for me. I remember back in August 1999 going to Boulder, Colorado to hear a lecture given by you and your writing partner, Vincent Bridges, when the Monument to the End of Time came out. It's great to be here for the unveiling of Secret of Alchemy.
Yeah, well, thanks. That was a great conference that we had back then.
Yeah, it was just absolutely ripe with all kinds of possibilities. Nobody really knew what was going to happen at the time of the millennium, and now here we sit 5 years later. What's your latest take, the forecast on where things are at in terms of fulfillment of prophecies and the era that we're moving into presently?
Well, it's getting more and more interesting lately. I think that where we're moving would seem to solidify the predictions that the Henday Cross and Fulcanelli and others like Nostradamus have made about this time. I think we're moving into a very, very serious time in world history, also a very hopeful time. I think that the recent events since 2001, 9/11, have given us all pause. I think that also that 9/11 is probably going to go down as a seminal event in world history, changing everything that's occurred afterwards, and including the last election last week. I think that all these things are culminating into something that is so big and beyond anything that's happened before that I can only stand in awe of Fulcanelli's predictions from 1926 and the Cross of Henday's predictions from almost 400 years ago. And when you include that in with the fact that every year since 1992, the weather has gotten much worse. The heat has every year is hotter than the year before. There are weather storms that shouldn't be, tornadoes in the south, and more hurricanes than ever. The whole thing begins to seem as if something's unraveling, and I think that something is history itself.
Yeah, well said. We have a lot of new listeners, Jay, probably even since the last time you were on the program, so let's take a moment to bring everyone up to speed. I'd like to give you a few terms and have you define them for us based upon your research. Let's start with Fulcanelli.
All right. Fulcanelli is really what you might call the last alchemist. As you probably know, but maybe many of your listeners do not know, alchemy is an ancient science that was handed down at least as far back as Egypt. India also had its own form of alchemy. Ancient India and ancient China also had their own its own form of alchemy. Alchemy is known today to be something that crazed men did to try to change lead into gold, but that's really just a cover story. The real story of alchemy is that it's a science. It's a holistic science that looks at nature and tries to understand what is going on in nature. It doesn't try to break things down. It tries to bring things together. It's kind of the opposite of science. I like to think of alchemy as the alchemy today as sort of where science is going. In shedding its ancient mystic origins, alchemy seems to be the only science that is bringing all of the disparate elements of science together. Fulcanelli, who wrote a book called Mystery of the Cathedrals in 1926, appears to be the last of a secret society, I guess. He repeats over and over in his book, Mystery of the Cathedrals, that he's nearly breaking his sacred vows by telling the reader the information. And so we can assume from this that Fulcanelli is a member of a group, of ancient order, that is preserving the knowledge in certain ways. One of the ways that they preserve knowledge is through monuments like Notre Dame Cathedral or the Great Pyramids, even, are really alchemical monuments. And so he wrote this book as kind of what I call the message in a bottle. He threw it out into the ocean and hoped that someone would eventually recover the message, decipher it, and figure out what he was saying. For some reason, no one really was interested in deciphering the message. They were more interested in who Fulcanelli was. Since he was anonymous, this created an intrigue, and many people went after that mystery. I was not all that interested in his anonymity. I was more interested in what it was he was saying. And for some reason, Vincent and I appear to be the only two people who really were interested in what Fulcanelli was trying to say. So in its own way, our two books are really the only analysis of Mystery of the Cathedrals and its intrinsic meaning, and there's very little concern in the books about who Fulcanelli was. So Fulcanelli was a very, very, very smart man who knew far more about this world than it seems possible at the time that he wrote the book. 75 years ago, 80 years ago now. So, in the end, Fulcanelli is telling us that this science that once existed everywhere is far more profound and advanced than our modern science is. And that was intriguing, and so I began trying to understand what alchemy really was as opposed to what the mythology was saying. And I think that's where all of the work that I do stems from, that trying to understand what alchemy is and what is the message that Fulcanelli is trying to tell us.
Very good. In 1957, the second edition of Fulcanelli's The Mystery of the Cathedrals was published. Strangely, it contained a new chapter not present in the original 1926 edition. It described an enigmatic cross in Henday, France, that remained unsolved, and I believe its message lost to history unless and then perhaps you and your writing partner, Vincent, come along and devote your life to solving it. Tell us about the cross at Henday, Jay.
Yeah, the cross of Henday really is the most intriguing thing that I've ever come across. No one knows who built it. It's at least 350 years old. It sits in a churchyard in a little small town in Henday, France, which is on the border with Spain. Louis XIV was married at Henday. Hitler visited the cross in 1940. Many, many strange people passed their way through Henday on their way to the alchemical schools of Spain, say in the 1200s and the 1100s. So Henday became a town, kind of a passageway, and someone built this cross, and we don't know who it was, in the churchyard. It was originally in the grave in the cemetery. It was moved to the churchyard in about 1830 or so, and it sits there, enigmatic, obscure. No one seemed to ever have paid much attention to it until Fulcanelli decided to give a look at it. He wrote his chapter on the cross of Henday. Since Fulcanelli supposedly disappeared from this world around 1929, this chapter must have laid somewhere waiting to be published. We're not exactly sure where it was or where it came from. There are indications that people like Schwaller de Lubitsch did know about the cross of Henday prior to the publication in 1957, but we're not sure about that. So pretty much no one, except for a couple esoteric scientists, paid attention to the cross of Henday, and since no one had really looked at it, and since if I could prove that what Fulcanelli was saying about the cross of Henday was true, then I would be able to say with some degree of certainty that the other things that Fulcanelli is saying in the book, Mystery of the Cathedrals, was true. So since this extra chapter had been added, I believe that Fulcanelli inserted the chapter on purpose to try to alert us. And while the chapter had great credibility in the 1926 edition, the fact that it was added to the republished edition some 30 years later really is mysterious. And since Cancellier, his editor, never really brings up the fact that there's an additional chapter, this is even more curious. So inside this chapter is this discussion of this strange cross, and this strange cross is quite remarkable. As Fulcanelli says, the maker of the cross had profound scientific knowledge about our universe. Well, how does a guy 350 years ago, before advanced telescopes and things, how do they know what's really going on in the world around us without the technology that you would think you would need? And I guess that's where alchemy comes in. But either way, what the cross is saying is that the world, that this age is coming to an end. And this age is coming to an end according to the time given on the cross right now. Between 1992 and 2012, something is going to happen. A lot of people speculate that it's a gate is going to open, or time itself is going to end, that this gate, when it opens, ends time. Kubrick in 2001 seems to understand this alchemical knowledge, and it's also telling us that there's a kind of a gate that's going to open or close. Anyway, we're not really sure, because the knowledge has been obscured so much by history that we can only speculate, and unfortunately that's all we can do, because we just don't know exactly what is going to happen. However, there would be a compression of events leading up to this, I would think. And I see the world right now, and I say there really is a compression of events, and that each year there seems to be more events happening that seem to be more out of control. And so Fulcanelli indicates that the chaos will be the determinant factor at the end of this age, and it looks like we are indeed falling into chaos. However, this is not to say that we are ending or that the world is ending. I want everyone to understand the cross of Henday is merely saying that this age is going to end, and that the whatever has preceded this ending, the thing that follows after the end will be nothing like what has happened before. So history, to me, is sort of an initiatory process leading the human race to this moment that we are all going to share. And it's going to happen. It is happening now. It's a stretched out moment. It's a 20-year stretched out moment where people like you, William, and Whitley Strieber, and me, and many others are suddenly beginning to understand things about this world that we never understood before. And we can all, you know, polish our fingernails and say, hey, we must be geniuses. But I'm wondering if maybe the knowledge is only now becoming available, and that's why we're discovering it.
Oh, I totally agree with that, Jay, and especially when you watch your DVD, The Secrets of Alchemy, you see how that force of synchronicity runs throughout your life's work. People, facts, places, maps just seem to show up. Talk about what that means to you. How did you tap into that force of synchronicity, and what does it mean to you?
Well, it's a great question. One of my favorite writers is a obscure French traditionalist.